There was a stranger who came into our town. He was tall and had a dark look about him, and a special brilliance was in his eyes. And when he looked at us, there was a feeling that he could look right down to the bottom. We may have been mistaken in this, but at the time no questions were asked. The questions always come later. All we cared about was the mystery we sensed in this stranger, and we waited to see what would happen. One evening that was different from any other, he got us all together in the big auditorium. He stood there on the huge stage. The only light was on him. We waited in the dark. Then, out of his tallness, came the chanting. First as a whisper we could hardly hear. The Flibberty Jib on the Flibberty Pop. The Flibberty Jib on the Flibberty Pop. It didn't make any sense. We were caught up in something we didn't understand. He had trapped us without our knowing it. Possibly it was his manner. But we came alive to him as he slowly moved us with his chant through the land of hush into insistent, savage, throbbing crescendos of ecstasy, as if it were the only thing we could do. We started to chant with him. The Flibberty Jib, the Bibberty Bop. The Flibberty Jib, the Bibberty Bop. And he was up on the high stage laughing with all his might, shouting, yes, yes, yes. But there were those among us who were jealous of his powers, who felt they should be on the stage with the light shining on them. They were against our hero and the chanting and our going to be with him every free moment. So little by little, a little later, these critics set to work to make nonsense out of the sense of what we were doing. And they succeeded. They destroyed our hero's faith in himself. He didn't have it anymore. After a few disappointing times in the big auditorium, the light gone out of him, we all stopped going. And the man who had once seemed so tall, and who now seems so much smaller, left our town saying, no, no, no. We lived through the boredom of the time that followed, telling each other pale stories of what once was, or what might have been if. We lived on history and hope. We did this until the miracle we never thought would happen happened again. Another stranger came into our town, and he too was tall and dark and had eyes that could look right down into the bottom view. And he got us all together in the big auditorium, and with the light on him, we were in the dark. He chanted, the Flibberty Jib on the Bibberty Bop. The Flibberty Jib on the Bibberty Bop. And we joined in, and the magic was in us, and he was laughing, and all his might was with him, and he was shouting, yes, yes, yes. But there were those among us who were jealous and so forth, you know. You know what they did. Little by little, a little later, they put us back on the narrow path. This is the way things have been in our town for as long as anyone cares to remember. By the way, how are things in your town?
Thank you. Thank you.
flowing. Ups will bring me down to the clouds of zero. I sometimes think that never lows so red the rose as where some buried Caesar bled. That every hyacinth the garden wears dropped in its lap from some once lovely head. Though many times I think of myself as nothing's boy, who climbs the spirals of his light, his heretic tick-tock muscle measuring, in its closed circle his blood's unfree-flowing. Ups will bring him down to the clouds of zero.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. This island that I'm calling me. Every time that I go there, you know who I see. You can see me and me more often than not, and that's pretty often. It's my favorite spot. Oh, there are plenty of spots called other than me, but there's someone else's. One look, and you'll see. You could try like a fool to be what you're not. The island you get is the island you got. God love you.
Ken Nordine. Ken Nordine.